Kachena Divoka, The Wild Duck by Leo Janáček, is a choral piece inspired by nature, written in 1917. It showcases Janáček's love for folk music and nature. Leo Janáček, from 1854 to 1928, was a Czech composer, musical theorist, folklorist, publicist, and teacher, known for his distinctive style blending folk influences with modernism. Born in Hukvaldi, Moravia, he was deeply inspired by Moravian folk music and language, which permeate much of his work. His music often captures the essence of Czech culture and landscapes, earning him a place among the foremost Czech composers, such as Dvořák and Smetana. The choir's voices mimic the movements of a wild duck, soaring gracefully and darting playfully. Janáček's music captures the energy of nature from calm movements to lively bursts. The translation of this piece is as follows. The wild duck flew from up high. The good lad, a skilled shooter, shot her in the side, under the left, or below the right leg. She cried, sitting on the water. She cried bitterly, called upon God. O God, my creator, my flight has ended. Poor duck, my flight has ended. I have protected my little ones. My tiny children do no harm. They sit on the Danube, drink the murky water, glide over hard sand. You tiny ducklings, fly after me, for we shall fly to the great Danube.
Our next piece is Esto Les Digo, which is a beautiful choral composition by Kinley Lang, offering a profound musical expression of faith and hope. Written in a contemporary choral style, Lang's work weaves together rich harmonies and expressive melodies to create a deeply moving musical experience. The title Esto Les Digo translates to, "This I Say to You," reflecting the piece's message of comfort and reassurance. Drawing inspiration from sacred texts, Lang's music evokes a sense of peace and serenity, inviting listeners to reflect on themes of love, faith, and spiritual renewal. Throughout this piece, Lang's sensitive handling of vocal textures and dynamics creates moments of exquisite beauty and emotional intensity. From gentle whispers to soaring climaxes, Esto Les Digo unfolds with a sense of grace and reverence, leaving a lasting impression on performers and audiences alike. With its profound spirituality and timeless beauty, Esto Les Digo stands as a testament to Kinley Lang's mastery of choral composition and his ability to touch hearts and uplift souls through the power of music. The translation is, "This I say to you, if two of you are put in accord here, in the earth to ask anything in prayer. My Father, which is in heaven, will give it to you, because where two or three are, there am I in the midst of them."
Thank you.
Mommy, Mama, Mami is a beloved Philippine folk song arranged by Lucio San Pedro, a celebrated Filipino composer. Born in 1913, San Pedro was known for his ability to blend traditional Filipino melodies with modern harmonies. In this arrangement, San Pedro brings out the lively spirit of Filipino culture. The song celebrates the mamamani, or the beekeepers, whose hard work is vital for producing honey, a cherished part of the Filipino cuisine. Through San Pedro's arrangement, the folk song's melodies are enriched with beautiful harmonies and dynamic contrasts, painting a vivid picture of the Philippines' vibrant landscapes and bustling marketplaces. The translation of the lyrics is as follows. We beekeepers live in Chimera. We beekeepers who are always busy. We beekeepers who never get tired. Among Guina Paquita, our queen in the hive, and in our village. We beekeepers, we have our joy. Golden peanuts, rings and bracelets, threads of peanuts. Our beloved Paquita, the queen of our hive. Please enjoy coming, Mama Mama.
Ching ching bong, ching bong, ching ching bong, ching bong, ching ching bong, ching bong.
Paquita, Majora, Samosa, Daya. Isakai, Our next piece tonight is The Dream of Shanghai. Zhu Sui is a famous contemporary women choral composer in China. Her works often draw inspiration from traditional Chinese culture or music, which she combines with modern compositional techniques. This piece is based on the flavor of traditional folk songs from Northwest China, arranged for choir. The main melody of the piece follows the traditional pentatonic scale of China, and the composer employs various textures and concise harmonic arrangements, making this piece beautiful and melodious. The text reads as follows. Green hills, azure seas, where drifting clouds kiss blossoms and breeze. Far-flung Shanghai, far-flung Shanghai. We tread pastoral tones, you and I. In that distant land, in that distant land, the ocean's hue paints with colors grand. In that distant land, in that distant land, the verdant prairie dreams a vibrant strand. We hope you enjoy it.
Oh. Our final selection. There we go. I had a first try time. Our final selection from university singers tonight will be Hosanna Fujila Duhan. This text and music is by Henry Yolanto. As we know, choral art originated from Christianity and became part of Western culture. However, for most Asian countries, choir singing is not traditionally part of their culture due to the non-Christian traditions. Christianity was introduced to Indonesia around the 17th century, bringing with it choral music. The next piece called Hosanna, Fujila Duhan, translated to Hosanna, Praise the Lord. It is a religious work composed by the contemporary Indonesian composer, Henry Yolanto. The composer has given these ancient lyrics a new style. They are translated as follows. Hosanna, praise the Lord, for the great is his love. Hosanna, praise God, glorify his name. Sing your thanksgiving songs joyfully. Give praise to the Lord, the glorious majesty of his name. Present all your life to God, the Creator. Sing to the Lord, the King of Kings. So great is his power over everything, yet he is willing to be human, to descend to earth, to atone for us all. We hope you enjoy.
Oh,
Naiman Shraga translates to the eight chestnut horses in Mongolian. It was composed by a contemporary Inner Mongolian composer, Tsu Unkabayar, in 1988 for the Inner Mongolian Youth Choir he founded. Tsu Unkabayar is one of the most representative contemporary Chinese choral composers. Based on his Mongolian cultural tradition, he has created a large number of choral works with traditional Mongolian music styles. Mongolian folk music oftentimes praises the horses because of their nomadic lifestyle. The Eight Chestnut Horses is a great example of this. The composer wrote short motifs with an energetic rhythmic language and clear-cut structure. A special rhythm pattern called the horse step pattern that represents one of the features of Mongolian folk music is present throughout this piece and provides a strong rhythmic energy for this work. The text translates as follows. The sun-shaped manes fly as wings. The moon-shaped tails wave behind. These chestnut horses shook the world scene and created history on this earth. Their golden hooves beat the soil. Their strong voices awoke Asia, making known the horses' might, earning much fame to our name, my chestnut horses. Please enjoy Naiman Shraga.
Thank you. this opportunity to thank you all so much for coming out tonight. We're very, very happy to have you here. Our final selection this evening is titled Shui Muji, which translates in English to water hen, and it actually refers to a water beetle that can fly and walk on the water's surface. This work is originally a children's folk song from the Chuang ethnic group in the Yunnan province of southwest China. The famous Yunnan composer Xiao Gong composed this piece based on this children's folk song, but kept the original dialect that we'll be performing it in this evening. It is also worth noting that the composer did not simply harmonize the tune, but instead added some modern compositional techniques, such as the use of nonsense syllables, tongue clicks, tone clusters, dissonances, glissandos, and aleatoric passages to create sound effects much like that of this water beetle. We hope you enjoy our final selection, Waterhead.